You know, I never know what. How do I hold this? Like, you know, can you look tough holding a wand? Like, or like, can you go for the classic, like, or this one? How come Steve never went? What up, nerds? Welcome back to the Nerdgasm. As always, I'm your host, Charles Fernandez.
Whoa!
Nerds, muggles, magical beings everywhere. Today we have a really, really special episode. It's been a really long time since I've discussed anything Harry Potter, which is wild because I'm a huge Potterhead. No, I'm a huge pot. Yes, I'm a huge pothead. I am also a huge Potterhead. So I'm a pot Potterhead. Wow. What kind of magic powers do you think? What kind of magic do you think I could use with that? I don't know. Maybe something like this? Ooh, magic. So as I was saying, haven't really talked about Harry Potter much on the show. Pretty much because ever since the movies ended and all the books were released, a lot of shit has gone down. You know, and I'm not even talking about She Who Shall Not Be Named. I'm talking about, like, The Cursed Child, which was fucking awful. And then those trash Fantastic Beasts movies, which it looks like they're not even finishing the series because it sucks. But that all changes today. One of the most anticipated video games, I would say, ever for a franchise. Because up until today, there hasn't really been a good video game set with Harry Potter. But that all changes. Because I got my hands on Hogwarts Legacy. And man oh man, let's be honest, you don't want to hear me talk about it. Why don't I show you? On this issue of the Nerdgasm, the nerd plays Hogwarts Legacy on the PlayStation 5. Spoiler warning!
This game is beautiful. The character design, cinematics, and environments are gorgeous. Whether you're exploring the secrets of the Hogwarts castle or discovering the deceptive Forbidden Forest, everything looks gorgeous. There were so many times I stopped in the middle of a mission and just took in all the details and wowness. Night or day, any season, Hogwarts looks fucking gorgeous. I mean, just look at this. It's so beautiful and so much detail is put into everything. Anything that was shown in the movies, they have captured perfectly. Hogwarts and Hogsmeade look exactly how we've all come to love them. Everything else is taken right from the descriptions in the books. That's part of what makes exploring the Hogwarts castle so much fun, because a lot of it was never seen in the movies. The actual magic, spell casting, and battles look amazing. I really love getting into these huge combat sequences with all the colors and magic spells flying around everywhere. It always looks so epic, and it's just one of those things where you have to take a moment and just awe in its beauty. All right. I've established how beautiful this game is to look at, but what about playing in it? The gameplay and actual scale of Hogwarts Legacy is fantastic. Use and customize a huge range of wardrobe and gear. You can master a variety of spells and skills, upgrade your skills, spells, and so much more. The customization is massive. Any seeds or plants you find can be used to make a variety of potions to help you throughout the game. You can save fantastic beasts in the wild from poachers and store them safely in hidden ecosystems inside the Room of Requirement. You can choose from multiple brooms or hippogriffs to get around the map. That's right, you can fly on a broom or a frickin' hippogriff. I prefer broom flying for certain things, but I can never pass up flying on a hippogriff. I mean, come on. And the whole map is actually pretty massive. It's not as huge as, say, Witcher 3 or other big-scale RPG games, but for Harry Potter, I think it's a massive map and there is a lot to do. It's not just Hogwarts and Hogsmeade. Those are the two most popular places, but there is so much more to explore. Except for Quidditch. But I'm gonna come back to that. There's actually a really good reason why Quidditch is not in this game. We'll discuss that more later. Another big thing with this game is not only do you get full customization of making your character, but you can actually choose to go the route of a good wizard, or you can become one evil motherfucker, and that includes using all the evil, unforgivable curses. For my first playthrough, I did decide to go the good boy Gryffindor. I kind of made like a little fuckboy Harry Potter, as we can see. For my second playthrough, I am gonna go full evil Slytherin Malfoy whiny asshole and see how dark and evil I can get in this game. And I want to kind of compare both gameplays to really see how big of a difference it is depending on what path you choose. Anyways, the spell combat is really good. Switching between all your spells and doing different combinations is fucking awesome. I go out of my way to take down these camps, and it's just so much fun going through all your spells and really just combo after combo. Also, having the added feature of using ancient magic is fucking sweet. Now, I've definitely established what it's like playing in this universe, but how does it feel? So yes, while playing on the PlayStation 5, this game does offer some haptic feedback features, but I really think they could have used so much more with it. For instance, whenever you learn a new spell, you have to cast it using your joysticks and following a specific pattern. I think if they had incorporated this on the haptic feedback touchpad and you actually had to use your finger to draw the line on the pad, that would have been a little bit more effective. I also think, like, when you're low on health or close to dying, a heartbeat indicator or something could be felt on the controller to really let you know, hey man, your wizard's gonna die. But overall, the haptic feedback features that they do have are great. I just think they can utilize it a lot more, and maybe we'll see more of those features in the sequel. Like any great RPG, there is a main storyline with specific missions, and there is a huge range of side quests. The main story is great and has a compelling story that ties really well into the Harry Potter timeline. The whole game is set 100 years before Harry Potter and the battle against Voldemort, so it's set in the late 1800s. It focuses on the growing tension between goblins and wizard kind and the approaching war between them. Your character discovers they have a very rare ability to see and harness ancient magic. The story also gives you the full experience of a Hogwarts student. You're sorted into a house by the Sorting Hat, a wand picks you at Ollivander's, you have to take your potions, defense against the dark arts classes, and everything that is expected for a Hogwarts student. All these classes are awesome because not only do they do a lot of fan service, but they help you learn new skills that you can upgrade and truly become the greatest wizard. And in regards to the whole Quidditch thing, I think they're really smart what they did. They knew it might have been a little bit too ambitious with the first game to give you everything they already have and then add in the element of Quidditch. Because Quidditch is going to have its own specific game mechanics. It's going to be very different than just flying around. The way they work it into the story is they really paint this picture that the current headmaster is a huge asshole. None of the professors like him. The students are afraid of him. Right at the beginning of the game, he announces that because there was an injury in the Quidditch season the previous year, he has canceled Quidditch altogether. I would have been pissed if this game was full of bugs or was broken because of them trying to rush adding in Quidditch. Now we have something to look forward to for the second game, and I guarantee you the Quidditch mechanics are going to be even better than if they had tried to rush it and squeeze it into this game. I love the story, the game is gorgeous to look at, it's so much fun to play, and I think I've done enough talking at this point. Why don't I just show you? Alright, here we go, Muggles. Giddy up.
Intramuros. Here we go. Going into a dark, deep cave.
Just a heads up, viewers. There's going to be a lot of this on here because why not, right?
Hogwarts, magic, Harry Potter.
Aren't you a little far from us?
Oh. Knew you'd eventually a bunch of gobbledygook goblins. Get ready to die, dummies. Expelliarmus. Fuck, I love it. I don't even know half of the time all the right names for the spells, but I'll just yell stuff like
Expelliarmus, Loomis.
Not Loomis. Lumos. I don't know. Whatever. They're all it's all gibberish. Anyway, so kicking some major ass here. Ooh, that's a troll. Yeah, this guy was an asshole. It was just barrel after barrel, spell. This is early in the game, like I don't even have really good spells yet. Here we go. Yeah, this is better.
Taking down some zombies.
What are they again? Infuri? Yeah. Yeah, Infuri? That's what we call it? Yeah. I know Harry Potter. I know what I'm doing. I've read the books. I know what's up. Stupefy.
Firing!
I think that one's Incendo. Anyways, this game's so much fun. I fucking love every minute. These guys are dicks. These zombie assholes, because they can only die by fire.
Incendo!
And then, oh, one just crawled up. Oh, I don't like that.
Oh, Harry Potter.
Yeah. Oh yeah, okay, so there we go.
Incendo!
It's kind of funny, like sometimes they just take like a fucking weird swing at you and it hurts you, but other times they just try and bite your face. Ooh, another sick transition.
Fucking spiders, mate! Fucking spiders!
I can't help but think of Ron every time. That wasn't me doing Ron, Jesus. I can't help but think of Ron every time I see spiders or anything Harry Potter related. I just think of him crying. But yeah, no, this is a lot of fun. Look at this.
Boom! Ancient magic.
See what I did there? It was amazing. Spiders are assholes. They're the worst. Yeah, they crawl from underneath you and shit. And if you're not paying attention, they'll jump you. And then you have, like, these little spiders. They're not even little. They're, like, the size of you. But then you have that giant motherfucker. Like, come on. Even Spider-Man would be like, this is ridiculous. And he's Spider-Man, okay?
Harry Potter. Harry Potter.
Ah, oh, see? Look at that. Oh, shit. Fuck, man. He jumped me from behind, jumped me in the front. Nowhere is safe with spiders. Ron has every right to fear them the way he does. They fucking suck. They're the worst.
Oh, now we're back to goblins. Damn.
Yeah, so all these goblins, this is like part of the goblin army. They have found a way to use a version of ancient magic as well, which is like, what? My favorite thing about this is when you can make them float in the air or pull them towards you because they're so little. It's kind of cute, you know? And I think sometimes they're like, you think this is funny? And you're like, yeah, a little bit, yeah. Little screams, come on. But I murdered a lot of them. Like, a lot of goblins are murdered because of me. So, you know, they're cute and all, but I will murder. What's he saying? Yeah. Got some beef. Boom. Done. Right? Look at that. Beautiful. Oh, peace!
Confringo. Burrito.
Boom. Done.
You've made your last mistake.
I do like their voices, though. It's great. What? No one calls me a puffskin? Is that what he said? What the fuck is that? I don't remember reading that in the book. Goddamn. Ooh! Lightning from Thor, courtesy of ancient magic. Levioso off the cliff. And you get a fire barrel. Nope, a fire barrel. There we go. Bam. Oh, this one's great too. Yeah, here we go. Give you no idea. So these are all the spells you get, and then you have to put them to specific spots there. And then when you hold R2 and press X, I can go invisible. I don't know what this accent is. It's awful. It's morphing. I think I'm offending all different dialects of English. What happened? Don't get high, kids, but do. It's a lot of fun.
Stay hidden and cast Protificus Totalus.
Okay. Protificus Totalus. Did I say it? Yeah? Protificus Totalus. It's a little weird when he whispers it. It sounds, you know, just a little weird. Like, I wouldn't sneak up on someone and then murder them, but right before I murder them, go, "Oh yeah, I'm murdering you." So this is a stealth, clearly a stealth mission that we had to do with the here. Goblins lair. So. I guess they're all hiding out here and they're fucking stacked with armor and shit. But, you know, that doesn't scare me because I'm going to go fuck this guy up. Murdered. You're murdered. Right? That's my catchphrase. You've been murdered by magic. Magic murder. Oh, that's what it is. You've been magic murdered. That's what I'm going to do right now. Here we go. Magic murder. Yeah, we all got to experience that together. I'm glad I got to take you on that journey. Alright, I'm... Fuck the sneaking around shit. I'll get one last guy and then, you know, let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Hey, what's that? You want some murder? Murder! Protificus Tataculus or whatever it is. Okay, so yeah, this is just an orgy of evil. We got evil wizards, we got gobbledygooks, and as you guys can see in the background, there's a fucking dragon. Yeah, these guys have been capturing dragons and are, like, making dragons fight each other for money and are, like, I don't know, breeding, like, you know, they're just being assholes. They're mistreating dragons, which I didn't even think you could do. Where's a Khaleesi when you need one, hey? This is a side quest, I'm pretty sure. But anyways, you discover like an underground dragon ring, and these dumb bastard wizards and goblins are, yeah, they're, I don't know, betting on dragons to fuck each other up, and it's bullshit. And I want a dragon, so I'm gonna save it. Look at that, see? Threw some cabbage. People hate cabbage. It'll chomp ya. Oh, fuck. I want that spell. But yeah, I have, like, you know, I can shoot fireballs and Expelliarmus. Oh, frozen! Bam! Look at that, see? Something with the cabbage, I think, did something. I don't know. I hate these gobbles. These gobbles. Why do I keep saying gobbles? They're goblins. I mean, sorry to the goblin population that I've been offending this whole episode with, you know, saying gobbles? I don't know. I'm a fucking idiot.
We need to save this dragon, Harry! Harry Potter!
Oh! The dragon has been saved. Now, does it understand that I have saved it and not that I'm the one that has been keeping it here? Because those are two very... Oh, okay. These guys are dumb. It'll probably figure out. I like that mask, though. Oh! This ain't the dragon from Shrek, let's just say that. This bitch is pissed! Done. Gone. Love it!
Voldemort!
Oh, she's... Oh. Get ready for your protector... Your protection spell, guys!
Pew!
There you go. Oh, cool. Yeah. This was fun.
That's a little funny to me. I feel like the dragon could have probably done that, but I guess that shows he's a friendly. And then this dragon's like, peace! I hope I never see you motherfuckers ever again.
We need to get out of here. It's falling apart. Hermione! Let's go, Hermione! Harry!
Yeah.
Okay, nerds! Wow, I think that's a good place to stop. Hogwarts Legacy, I'm blown away with it. I am just beyond impressed. It is amazing. I can't put it down, so it goes without saying, but I'm gonna say it. Hogwarts Legacy is officially nerd approved. Magic! Yeah, nerd approved. Pew! All right, nerds, that's it for this issue of the Nerdgasm. Thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to like, comment, share, and most importantly, make sure to subscribe. That's right. Wherever you see subscribe, just fucking click it. And then you're subscribed and it's done. I got a lot of great new content coming out. It's going to be a big year for the Nerdgasm. The Nerdy nominations are going to be announced very, very soon. Best and worst of 2022. Don't want to miss it. All right. And that's it. Thanks so much for stopping by. And we'll see you next time on the Nerdgasm. Woo!